Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Hello friends, welcome to Vastech channel. In this presentation, I am going to cover the important concept, that is programmable logic device. Programmable logic device, or you will call this as a PLDs. So it is a special or a general, it is a general classification of IC. In this, we encounter different types of device. One is called as a programmable ROM. Second one is a PLA, programmable logic array. Third one is a programmable array logic. So according to your syllabus, you are going to study PLA and PAL. PROM is not there in your syllabus. So now, first we have to see what is the difference between all these different types of device. In more general, all these device contains two section, input section and output section. The input section is the array of AND gate. Output section is the array of OR gate. These gates are either fixed, that means you can't alter, or something called as fusible linked, that means you can program it. So based on the configuration, we have to see which array is fixed and which array is programmable. So you can see here different types of configuration here. This is a programmable ROM where input is fixed AND array, output is a fusible OR array. Then PAL, input is a fusible AND array, output is a fixed OR array. Then PLA, input is programmable and output is also programmable. So general configuration you can see here. This is the general general configuration of PLA, I can say. PLA, programmable logic array, where it contains input OR AND gate, array of AND gate, and output array of OR gates. And here this star marks, you see, this is called as fusible links. These are called as fusible links. This can be programmed based on the different types of fundamental terms. So these programmable logic device are used to solve Boolean expression. So now we will follow. Now we will move to first one, that is called as a programmable logic array, where both input and output are fusible. That means you can program it. So we will see now a type of problem. So here it is given function F1, this is the function, F2 is the function. You have to implement this circuit with the PLA with the 3 input, 3 product term and 2 output. That is 3 into 3 into 2 PLA. That means this indicates 3 input, 3 product terms and 2 output. That is, this is indicates OR gate, and this indicates AND gate, and this indicates a variable. So now write down the 3 input variable, and here represent the function 1 and function 2. Function 1 you can see 3, 5, 7, M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. Like that you represent this one. Once you represent this one, then try to solve it by using Boolean K-map. Then you will get product terms, these are the product terms, these are the answer for the K-maps. that is BC AB bar and BC AB bar and AC, and implementation of this one. So implementation of this one is simple. First input A, B, C in between OR gate, that will form A bar, B bar, C bar, and three AND gate, 1, 2, 3. Now output function is connected to, function one is connected to one OR gate, function two is connected to one OR gate. Function one contains AC, BC. Function two contains AC and AB. So that is the answer for this one. So here function one, you have to solve it for function one and function two. You will get that one you have to implement here. Now we will see, implement this following function. So now, this function also, following function 0, 1, 3, 4, 0, 1, 3, 4, and function 2 is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5. So try to solve this one. Try to solve this one. When you try to solve this one, you will get answer something like this. BC bar, AC bar. And here you will get, here you will get, one is, one term is AB bar, that is this term AB bar. Second term you will get, second term is A bar B. A bar B, this one. Third one you will get, third one you will get A bar C. These are the three terms. So when you see how many fundamental terms are here, this is one, this is two, this is three, and this is four. This fourth term is common. So I need a four AND gate. So you may ask one more thing here. Instead of this one, to come to make a group of this one, one, I can combine like this also. That time I will get one more term, that is here you can see BC bar. If you group like this, one, one, two, two, three, four, five, six. Sorry, this term is not there. Five terms you will get. Total five terms you will get. So if you group like this, you need five AND gates. That's why what we did grouping. So sometimes they will say, implement this one by using 3 into 4 into 2. That means you have to use AND gate 4 only, not more than that. That's why while grouping here, dear students, please see here, while grouping here, we did grouping like this. One group is like this, second group like this, third group like this. If you do like this, you will get common term here, one common term. So total number of terms is 1, 2, 3, 4. That you can implement it. You can see here in the diagram here. So ABC, 4 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, and to implement the two functions, I need two OR gate here, F1 and F2. Now implement the following function using PLA once again. So you can see, this is the one more solution, this one. Function is given, and K-map, and final implementation. So here, three functions are there. So we need three OR gate. And how many AND gates? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How will come to know how many AND gates are required? You see here, when you see this one, X bar Y Z, one term. Second term is XZ bar. Third one is this one. Fourth one is this one. Fifth term is common. Five AND gate is required. And to implement this three function, three OR gate is required. So input is a visible AND array, output is visible OR array, and we are implementing function by using AND array and OR array. In the exam, they will give function. In the exam, they will give function like above, you can see here. And they will ask you to implement this one by using PLD or PLA 3 into 5 into 3. That means you have to use 3 variable and you have to use 5 AND gate and you have to use the 3 OR gate. First you see whether you can implement this one by using this one. Here you see 1, 2, 3 functions are there. So OR gate is matching. And 3 variables are there. This term is also matching. Only thing is I have to solve this one by K-map and I have to find out number of SOP terms. Then I have to see whether SOP terms can be implemented by 5 AND gate. So next, implement a 7 segment decoder using PLA. This is very simple. You know 7 segment BCD2 in the last class we saw this one 7 segment decoder BCD2 7 segment. So here you can see one side these are the BCD inputs and this is PLA, this is the output and that is connected to the 7 segment. So now what you have to do is here first write all the combination of ABCD. Even though ABCD you will get 16 combinations, you have to write only 9 combinations because you know 0 to 9 10 combination you have to write. BCD is used to represent decimal 0 to 9. So you cannot write 16 combinations. So first write all the 9 combinations. That is 0, 0, 0, 0. This is the first combination. 0, 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0, 1. See here. 0, 0, 1, 0. Like this, all these combinations connected to AND gate. Output. For this is for A, this is for B, this is to display C. This is for, this is for D segment, this is for E segment, this is for F segment, this is for G segment. Now, truth table is important here. We will see the truth table. See the truth table here. To represent 0, in 7 segment, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? These are the 7 segments. So, this is the segment A, this is B, this is C, this is D, this is E, this is F, and this is G. To represent 0, I should forward bias all the LED segments except G. That is reverse bias. That's why all A, B, C, D, you have to fuse it. Clear? To represent one, which one all you have to fuse? You have to fuse, B and C. To represent one, you have to fuse B and C. Yes. See here, the particular student, did mistake here. So, to represent one, you need to fuse this and this segment. That means here, it should be like this, not this and all. This. To represent 2, to represent two, you have to fuse all the segments. To represent three, you have to fuse segments like this. To represent four, you have to fuse segments like this. This is four. Five, six, seven is something like this, not like this. So based on that, you have to fuse here all these. Then finally, you convert this into K-map. So you convert this into K-map representation. And this will be the final answer. So here you can see, this is for A, this is for B, this is for C, D, E, F and G. So now, my dear students, here some mistakes are there. So let me go to textbook. Yeah, you can see here. This is the input. This is the input, and this is to represent zero, you have to fuse these LEDs. This is A, this is B, C. To fuse one, this one. To fuse two, these LEDs are required. To fuse three, A, B, C, D, and G. A, B, C, D, and G. Like this required. So here I think there is no K-map, because if you use K-map, that will take a long, lengthy method. So according to your textbook, this is sufficient. So 7 segment LA, this one by using PLA. Now, the next one, VLA can be also used to represent BCD to access 3 code converter. Here I am not going to solve once again K-map. So K-map, you have to solve it or you have to practice it. But I will tell the idea here. First, you have to represent BCD code for 0 to 9. Then convert this to XS3 code. What do you mean by XS3 code? You take this BCD code 0000, and for that you add 3. XS3. Then you will get 0011. That is 3. 0, 3. For 1, if you add 3, what is the value? 4. This is 4. This is 5. This is 6. This is 7. This is 8, 9, 10, 11. And this is 12. Now, after this, you have to solve this one. You have to solve this one. E0, E1, E2, E3. By using K-map. So you can see here K-map. So you need to practice this one in the exam directly. If you try this one, then you have to spend time. So you need to practice this one. Then after that, you have to implement this one. Once again, please remember, here also you represent this one diagram, by using block diagram, because this will take lengthy diagram. So if you want to implement this one by using AND or gate array, then that will take lengthy. So represent like this from the exam point of view. So next one is implement a gray to binary using PLA. We know binary, and this is the gray code. We know how to convert gray into binary or binary into gray. So you should know this one first, how to convert binary into gray. For example, 000 000, this is the gray code. 001, you take 0001. Let me take a blackboard. So this is binary. Here I will represent this one is by using binary, and this is gray. Please remember, binary is a weighted one, weighted code. Gray is a unweighted code. There is no weight for it. Binary has got weight for the particular bit, like 8, 4, 2, 1. But gray codes are used in certain applications. So now binary will take 0, 0, 0, 0. Gray is the same, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now we will take 0, 0, 0, 1. To convert this one, I will write here 0, 0, 0, 1. First represent 0 MSB as it is. Then add this one to this one. 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0. 0, 1, 1. So this is 1. 0, 0, 0, 1. Now we'll take one more. 0, 0, 1, 0. To convert 0, 0, 1, 0. 0, 0, 1, 0. Represent MSB as it is. Add this one to this. 0. Add this one to this one, add this one to this one. That is nothing but 0, 0, 1, 1. This is binary to gray. Now, how to convert gray, this gray to binary? So, for that, represent this one, MSB as it is. Now, add this one to this, add this one to this, 0, 0, 0. 0, 1, 1. 1, 1, 1, 0, ignore carry. So see, this is the binary. This is gray. This is binary. So binary to gray, gray to binary conversion. So you can see here. After that, once again, implement this one by using kmap. My dear students, once again, here also you have to solve this one by using kmap. So please remember, you take this bit as G0, G1, G2 and G3. Use K-map like this. So here it is, you use this is B0, B1, B2 and B3. So here you represent B0 and B1, here B2 and B3. So K-map. Try to solve this one by using a K-map. So in the K-map, you represent initially G0. Like this is M0, M1, M2. This you represent and answer. This is for G0. Now once again, one more K-map for G1. One more K-map for G2. One more K-map for G3. Then you have to represent that one by circuit diagram. As I said previously. Now, hardware description language. Hardware implementation. SGL implementation of 8:1 MUX. Very important from the exam point of view. So you can see here module and end module. Give name to the module MUX 8:1 and all the input you and output you represent here. You know when you take 8:1 multiplexer, 8:1 contains three control lines A, A, B, C and data lines D0 to D7 data line, 8 data lines and output line Y that you have to represent here. Then once again represent input and output. Y is a type of a register. Always statement you use. Always at either any of this will change. A or B or C or D0, D1 or D2 or D3, D7. Case ABC based on the case ABC. What are the case ABC? So case ABC. So ABC can take 8 values, that is, 1 is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Last one is the default case, if you want, you can add it. 0, case 0 means 0, 0, 0, y can take D0, otherwise y can take D1, otherwise y can take D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. So this is the representation for implementation by using 8:1 multiplexer. Now design 4:1 multiplexer using conditional, assign and case statement. How to design conditional or assign statement and case statements? So by using case statements, very simple, 4:1. So 4:1, how many control lines are there? Two control lines are there, A and B. Two control lines are there. How many inputs are there? Four inputs are there. How many output? One output. Represent here. This is the input. This is the output. This is the register. Always case. Only two value, A, B. What is the combination of A, B? Four values. What and all? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. For that, value of Y, D0, D1, D2, D3. Now, we'll see. Assign statement. In the exam, they will ask implement 2:1. So I am using digital principles and application book PDF from Donald P. Leach and Malvino, 7th edition for the reference. This video is not for commercial purpose. This video is only to help our students. So here you can see module MUX 2:1. Input, output, but if you use case statement, depending on the number of variable, case statement will increase. But if you use assign statement, you can see here. Single statement, Y can take A, D0, A, D1. You think A is 0. 0 is associated with the D0. A is 1. 1 is associated with the D1. In between or. So this is assign statement. Otherwise, one more method of writing assign statement is this one. Y is equal to A question mark D1 is to D0. That means here question mark, if it is 0, that means A is 0, then it will take value D0. If it is 1, then A will take value, if A is 0, Y will take the value D0. If this question mark is 1, then Y will take the value D1. Is it clear? If it is 0, Y will take the value D0. If it is 1, Y will take the value D1. So now, next. So you can implement this one by using if and else statement also. So in the exam, see, they can ask you like implement by using assign statement, case statement, if else statement. You should know how to implement. See here, same question, 2:1 multiplexer. 2:1 multiplexer. Output is Y, register, always at the rate, always at A. This is always at A, D0, D1. Either A can change or this can change. If A is equal to 1, then Y is equal to D1, else Y is equal to D0. Case statement we know, assign statement we know, this is if else statement. Next one. Now design 4:1 multiplexer using case statement and assign statement. Somewhat complicated. First, let me explain with the case statement. We have already seen case statement like 4:1 multiplexer, two control lines and data lines and output. Define input, define output, register, always. Then case A and B. A and B, 0, 1, 2, 3. Y can take D0, D1, D2, D3. Please remember, always case should end with the end case. Single word, there is no space between end case and end module. Don't write like end space module, end space case. No, single word. This is easy. We have seen. Now, how to implement this one? Here, you see this one. So, Y can take value. So, let me use black whiteboard and explain. So I will rewrite this one. Assign statement is used here. This is assign is equal to, assign y is equal to a question mark b question mark d3 is to d2, that is the one, bracket close. Once again, in between this one, once again, B question mark D1 D0 bracket close. So now let me, you have to solve internal loop first here. But what I will do, I will take here this as x and this as y and try to explain first. Now when you take x and y, what is this? Y is equal to a question mark x is to y. Simple. If the question mark is 0, y is equal to, I will take different value. Don't confuse here. So let me take a different value here, not x is to y. So I will take different value. If I take x and y, you may confuse. I will take p and q. So here p is to q. So if a is equal to 0, then y is equal to q. If a is equal to 1, then y is equal to p. Now you have to solve this one first. So we'll see now here, this one. First we'll take this loop. When b is equal to 0, b is equal to 0, internal loop, y can take a value d2. When b is equal to 0, y can take value d2. Otherwise, it can take value d3. Similarly, when b is equal to 0, here, b is equal to 0, it can take value d0 or it can take value, it can take value d1, right? Now, this is internal loop. Now, what is a? A can take two values, 0, 0 or 0, 0, 0 or 1, 1. That means you will get four combinations now, you see here, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So d0, d1, d2, d3. First you have to solve this one, then you have to solve this one. So let me repeat here once again to make more clear. So you see, first you have to try to solve this one. You have to solve this one. So now first write here. When b is equal to 0 and 1, value is d2 and d3. Now you use this one. And b is equal to 0, 1, value is d0 and d1. Now a can take two values, 0, 0 and 0, 1. I'm sorry. 1, 1. This gives four combinations. Clear? So you can see here, assign single statement is used to implement a 4 is to 1 multiplexer. Now next one is bus representation in STL. Now implement DMUX port 1 to 4. DMUX means what? We know it has one input and many output. Here 1 to 4 means this is one input D, this is output Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, and control lines are A and B. Clear? So now you can see here module DMUX 1 to 4. S is nothing but control lines. S can take value 0 and 1. This representation is called as bus representation. Once again input is D. Then once again output is Y. Bus representation. Y can take Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3. So this is the way of representing reg. Then always S or D. Case statement. Case. So first one is when input is in the binary form like 100, output is in the binary form 0001. 4 bits, 4-B, no, sorry, this symbol B means 4 bits in the binary form. So this bit will be 1. Here this bit will be 1. Second case, this bit will be 1. Third case, this bit will be 1. And fourth case, this bit will be 1. So this is the bus representation in the HDL. So here, a verilog code for a digital circuit given below. Circuit is given. Like inputs are A, B, C and output is Y. When A is less than B, it should display something like this. Else if when A is greater than B, it should display something like this. Or else Y is equal to C. It has to display something like this. For that, this is the code. When A is less than B, if A is less than B, Y is equal to 001. How to write this one in this format? Y is equal to 3, this symbol B. B means bits or binary 001. Else when A is greater than B, Y is this one. Or else Y is equal to C. This is the solution. So my dear students, with this we have solved data processing circuits. The second part of this one. So data processing circuit is completed. The second part of this one is nothing but flip-flop. So in the next session you can see the presentation related to latches or flip-flops.